Hi guys, welcome to this week's broadcast. I'm Gabe.
And I'm Kara.
Here's Logan and Dylan with timestamps and new toys.
Hey Montgomery, it's Dylan. We're excited to bring you more and more news this year. If you guys don't have enough time, we understand. We're going to introduce to you guys a new feature that will help you guys check out what segments you want to watch. A new part of the class this year is going to introduce to students to our editors. We're going to timestamp each broadcast. What that entails is every broadcast we're going to go through, we're going to put in the description of our YouTube video what time links up to what story. There'll be hyperlinks so you can actually click on it and it'll take you right to the story. If you guys want to check out a certain segment, make sure to check out our description and it'll be there every week. Thank you again for your viewership.
Up next is our sports update with Colton Hessler and Colton Hands.
All right, I'm Colton and I'm here with Clint, and we're talking about the football team's first win. So, what helped you guys achieve this win on Friday?
Just being together as a team all week, hard Monday through Friday, coming out Friday as a team.
And what does this win mean for you guys being a team?
Well, now we have our first one out of the way in week four. We have another 6 weeks to focus on competing and winning another game or two, and move up the ladder for playoffs.
All right. Thank you for your time.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Alex, and after our first interview with Hunter Bubman, he has also been named Athlete of the Week. This is what his coaches have to say about him. Hunter Bubman ran for 132 yards and a touchdown against Wellsboro. This seems like a normal stat line for Hunter, but this is a Wellsboro team that has scored 50 points on us by halftime in the past 2 years. And Hunter's score led the way to a 6-6 halftime score this year. And he did all of this at quarterback. Hunter Bubman changed positions for the first time in his football career, which extends back to beyond B-ball. And he did this to help our team get through adversity. That is the kind of leader and captain that Hunter is on our team. Hunter followed that performance by rushing for 313 yards and 3 touchdowns against Sarah.
I'm Colin. I'm here with Jessica. So your soccer team had their first win recently. Could you tell me a little bit what your team did to achieve this goal?
Well, we all worked really hard and didn't give up. We went in double overtime, and we were obviously getting a little tired. But we had something to look forward to. Homecoming was after, and we just really wanted that first win. So we just kept working toward it.
Okay, what does this mean for the future of the soccer team?
It's something really good to build off of because we're only 3 games in, and our schedule is looking pretty good, and I think we can win a lot of the other ones. So.
Okay, thank you for your time.
Yep, thanks.
Here's our story on the Strong Team with Cade, Kevin, and Joe.
So I'm here today interviewing Mrs. Virchel about the Strong Team. So Mrs. Virchel, how'd you get involved in the Strong Team?
Mrs. McNair and I actually sat down last year and just were brainstorming some positive things we could do around the school and how we could get kids more involved, and that's how Strong developed. So.
And what are your plans for this year?
So far we've been trying to do student and teacher or staff recognition every week. That's what you guys have heard, with the teachers or staff members being mugged, and then our student choices each week. And then we're also going to try to do some more things. Like prior to this year, we usually called them incentives. We're going to try to switch that up a little and give more student choice to that. And maybe even some more things. So we're excited about this year.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
Hi, I'm here interviewing Jalen about the Strong Team. So Jalen, how did you get involved?
So what happened was teachers got together and picked students they felt had a passion for change and wanted to see a difference made in our school, and have you one of them.
And what purpose does it serve?
So the purpose of service is this student pride team. We get together and we see student accomplishments for what they are. Not every teacher knows what every student does on day to day, and the students do. So we try to recognize hardworking students and hardworking teachers as a whole, because they're student of the month, but not necessarily teacher of the month. So we decided to do teacher of the week, and then we pick 2 students every week to receive a treat.
Okay, thank you.
Take a look at the art preview with Danielle and Kara.
Hello, I'm Kara Bosley, and I'm here with Ms. Sampson to ask her a few questions about art. So, Ms. Sampson, what are your ideas for art this year?
We have quite a few this year. One of the main ideas that we're going to be doing is completing the mural that should be done within the next few weeks. That's going to be installed in the library, in the media center. So we're super excited about completing that. We are also hopefully going to be able to do the bathrooms. We're going to do a little remodeling through the arts, make things a little more positive, giving everybody some quotes of positivity and feeling good about oneself. What else are we going to do this year? Oh yeah, we're going to have a Coach and Vera Bradley bingo to raise funds to install the new kiln that we just received from PTO.
And how do you think these ideas will benefit the school?
Oh, absolutely. The arts program is insanely important, so we need to support it as much as possible. So this is one avenue, and we're looking to others as well.
Are you looking forward to this art club year?
Oh my gosh, yes. We've got some new students that are involved, so we're super excited about that. The bigger the better. So if you're still interested, please contact me.
Thank you so much.
Now let's get ready for an in-depth look at the Radio Reading Buddies.
We're here with Mrs. Orr to talk about Reading Buddies. And for everyone who isn't familiar with it, would you like to explain what Reading Buddies is?
The Reading Buddies is a program that Mr. Basella started with the football players, and I believe the cheerleaders have joined in this year, where they come over to the elementary and they read a story to our kids.
Do your students look forward to the Reading Buddies throughout the week?
Absolutely. The kids really look forward to the older kids coming over and getting to know the football team. And the football team are great role models for our kids, and I'm looking forward to having the cheerleaders come over too.
And what was your initial reaction when you first heard about the Reading Buddies program?
Well, I thought it was a great idea. My kids first were a little nervous when somebody new comes into our classroom and these big guys in their uniforms, but it's turned out that they've really looked up to them and look forward to coming here and also going to look for their number at the football game.
Thank you for your time.
Thank you.
I'm here with Mr. Bazella. So, how did the idea for Reading Buddies come about?
Well, the first year we did some work with the youth football team and the A team and the B team and the flag team outside of school, and I saw how these kids really gravitated towards our upperclassmen and even, you know, the 10th graders, and I thought, how do I put this to good use? And, well, you know, I'm an English teacher, so I know everybody loves to read, and so I asked the elementary if they wanted some upper-class football players come on a Friday when they're all dressed in their jerseys, kind of represent the football team, get the kids pumped up, but also to stress why reading is a good thing. And that's how it started, and I'm very happy with where it's become.
That's awesome. How has Reading Buddies affected you and your football players?
I think it makes us understand that there's more to this being on this team than on Friday nights. And, you know, we as a coaching staff try to stress this with the boys, you know, that you learn so much more from the game of football than just X's and O's. This is one of the things that I kind of pride myself about our team, is that, you know, we're giving back to the community, but also the sense that our players get by going into these classrooms and helping out, hopefully gives them a blueprint for their future. Many of them will be fathers someday. I think, you know, many of them will work with people in whatever career that they choose. And this, knowing how to plan ahead, knowing how to facilitate a discussion, or because some of them do that, some of them get into small groups and discuss. Knowing how to do that with a group of people, especially ones you have to really maintain focus with, I think is going to help them out in the long run.
Great. Thank you for your time.
Thanks.
Now let's take a look at our homecoming recap.
Hi, I'm Colton Bauer here with Katie Forstall. How did it feel to win homecoming?
I was honestly really surprised. Me and all the other girls in there are amazing, and I didn't think I'd win, but here we are.
Katie, do you have any advice for the upcoming senior class of next year?
Just have fun. Don't worry about anything too much. Get in college, if that's what you're doing. Figure yourself out.
All right, well, thank you.
Yep.
Hi, I'm Colton Bauer here with Riley Strongfall. Homecoming royalty right here. So Riley, how did you feel about winning homecoming?
It was an exciting experience. Being there, being on the court in the first place, it's very nice to know that everyone looks up to me.
Do you have any advice for the upcoming senior class of next year?
It's not about just winning. It's about being there with your friends and being a part of something bigger than yourself.
That was very touching. Have a good year. Thank you.
Now to the performing arts preview.
Hey, I'm Mackenzie and I'm here with Carson. What's going on in Virtuoso this year?
Well, we really have a lot planned in Virtuoso. We're going to go to D.C. in November, as well as we're doing The Crucible as our play in December, and we're also doing the musical Mamma Mia. Also, we have a music recital planned called Bach and Rock, which is going to be pretty sick. Y'all should come see it.
All right, thank you.
Hi, I'm Carson Bloom, and I'm here with Whitney Bolden, the drum major of the band. Now, Whitney, are you doing anything interesting in the band this year?
Yeah, we are actually. About mid-May, we're going down to Virginia for about 4 days. We're going to perform at Busch Gardens for a couple of those days, and that'll be really exciting.
Thank you, Whitney.
You're welcome.
Now on to the health fair with Mason and Kelly.
Last week, our guidance and physical education departments combined to present a health fair entitled Healthy, Wealthy, and Wise. Area counselors, business owners, and motivational speakers came together to offer age-relevant topics to students in grades 7 through 12. This wellness fair is an introduction to our new initiative in offering our students support and encouragement beyond our traditional counseling services.
Let's take a look at the mobile ag trailer.
Hi, I'm Jaden, and I'm here with Alex. So Alex, we heard that you helped out with the mobile ag trailer. What did you do?
I mainly just kind of walked around and I made sure all the kids were doing what they were supposed to do. It was more kind of like a supervising thing, but they had me out there because I live on a dairy farm. So I was just kind of supervising and like teaching kids a little bit about it.
Awesome. How did you, working on a dairy fire, help you teach these kids and help you help these kids?
Well, they were out there, they were making glue from milk. So, I mean, I have a lot of kids' milk, so I just, I knew more about the, I knew a lot about the product, and I knew a lot about the field, so I could really help them out.
Thank you very much. Hi, I'm Jaden, and I'm here with Jake. So, Jake, we heard that you were helping out with the mobile ag trailer. What did you do?
So, what I did was I helped the kids, there's different types of food, all the different types of food, where, like, they acted as plant parts. So, say, they had a stem, which that was a marshmallow, and they had a mandible, which was a clothespin. So you take the clothespin and you chew on the marshmallow, and if it damaged the marshmallow, then the mandible would be considered as a dangerous insect. And that's what we did there.
Now, how did you helping out with this affect the students' learning?
I feel like, the older kids, seniors, or even juniors, helping out with the younger kids, it affected them a lot because, like, they look up to us older kids, and I probably thought that it was pretty cool for bigger kids to come help us.
Awesome. Great time.
Yes, no problem.
Hi, I'm Jane, and I'm here with Mrs. Snyder. So, Mrs. Snyder, we know that you had the mobile eye trailer out back. How did you think that this affected the kids' learning?
I think it was a great experience for the students. It was here for an entire week. Every class got to go out and participate in a hands-on science activity. It helped them because it was related to the Pennsylvania science standards, especially with environment and ecology. And also, they had a chance to experience the scientific process and the importance of that, which also meets our science and technology standards.
Awesome. Thank you very much. Hi, I'm Jaden, and I'm here with...
This is Gottenauer, and I'm here to talk about the science lab. So my kids are in there right now. They're having a blast. It's something that I can take away and use in my own classroom. I know I really like to keep things hands-on, and they're loving it in there right now. I really like to incorporate STEM into the lessons that we have. So I know one of the projects that they work on is with chemical reactions, where they will use milk and they're going to turn it into butter. And one of our lessons that we use in our marketing period is with chemical reactions. So I know I'm definitely going to pull that away to then use it in my own classroom because they love how hands-on it is. The questions that she's asking, or higher order thinking, it's really getting them involved And I really think that they're enjoying it, so I have a lot to take away from it.
Thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Hey, what's up? I'm here with Evan. Today, we're going to learn how to shoot hoops.
All right, so you're going to shoot a free throw, which is 2 points, all right?
All right. Now I'm going to show Evan how it's really going. Okay, Evan, what's the measure made of?
Now why don't we take a little gander over to question of the week.
Have you seen or heard anything about the new Mac? And what are you most excited about?
Well, I haven't seen a lot personally. I've heard lots of great stuff about it. Everything's new and improved. And we were up there recently for the football game for homecoming, which was awesome. But I'm definitely excited to go visit and see all the different sporting events coming up.
Thank you, Senor Gordo.
You're welcome.
Have you seen anything about the new Mac or heard anything about it? What are you most excited about?
I have, actually. I've even gotten a tour of the new Mac, and I'm really excited for the amount of space we have to store stuff, the amount of areas that all the different teams and sports can use. It's really cool.
Thank you, Mr. Grant.
No problem.
Thank you for watching this week's broadcast. I'm Gabe.
And I'm Kara.